art features light and the movement of space and time, condensing the colors and the sounds of sensibility and reality. Ideas are all over, equally unexpected and correlated to what cannot be defined without contradictions. Art functions to make existence viable and capture what logic and numbers cannot illustrate.
Louisa Richter is born in 1928 in Bezigmund, a small city at the confluence of the Neckar and Enns rivers. She grows up in Hitler's Germany. During that period, schools are closed, and art forms such as abstraction and expressionism are forbidden. However, Louisa was raised in a progressive home in a metaphysical and intellectual environment. She studies in one of Rudolf Steiner's schools. From childhood, she demonstrates a talent for drawing and painting. And in 1946, after the end of the war, her father enrolls her in the Metz Academy of Art in Stuttgart.
In one of my first classes with Mertz, he said something that impressed me. Look at the atmosphere, autumn. Look at the falling leaves, how these elements create their own world. Suddenly, someone getting off the train drops his ticket on the ground. The combination of all these elements on the ground can give you an idea of the principles of collage. When you translate this onto a canvas, it needs a unifying force to become a composition. Composition is the base and theme of every work of art, be it music, painting, or poetry.
In 1947, Louisa is ready to move forward. She is accepted into the Free Academy of Arts in Stuttgart. There, she learns to use and combine colors and to translate the human body onto large-scale canvases.
At the Academy of Arts, we were under the tutelage of post-expressionist painter Hans Fahnle and Rudolf Müller. It was interesting the ways and techniques they used to make us become aware of how to translate the three dimensions into two, and to sensitize us in the use of the brush and the pencil. I learned that the brush stroke forges a connection with the insight, and that the great masters from Michelangelo to Klee developed a psychological game with the stroke. Fenler and Müller wanted to make us understand how to capture the essence of the themes we were painting and the possibility of expression with the brush, how to portray our feelings and add vitality to a painting, how to find that something that's underneath the form, behind the colors. They wanted to sensitize us to translate all these elements of reality onto the canvas. Entre la realidad y la traducción hacia un lienzo.
In 1949, Louisa is granted acceptance at the prestigious Stuttgart National Academy of Fine Arts. There she studies with Willy Baumeister, one of the most recognized representatives of European abstractionism and the avant-garde of the 1950s.
Baumeister, my mentor, was very subtly inspiring his students. We were all influenced by Professor Baumeister and his unique way of teaching art. In his art classes, he talked about literature. Baumeister talked to us about Zen Buddhism, the Tibetan Book of the Dead, Gilgamesh, and also about communism, ideas that Leger, Cocteau, and Sartre explored in great depth. All this was used by Baumeister to confront us with ourselves in ways that expanded our possibilities. He didn't want us to fall into the cliché. He wanted us to be artists capable of developing a personal climate through intellectual reflections.
Tomamos decisiones intelectuales un propio clima de la posibilidad.